An officer opens fire on Fountain Square, killing a teen suspect who was holding a gun. Now tonight, we have new video showing how it all happened. Laura Borchers is live tonight at Yateman's Cove, where police say it all began.
The first words from the police chief tonight were condolences for the Devon Molins family. Now, he is the 16-year-old who is dead after fighting with a Cincinnati cop. The new police chief worked to be transparent, releasing to us video of the entire incident.
And he refused to comply with the officer's directions, causing the officer to take hold of Devon's arms to prevent him from running. A violent struggle ensued, lasting 1 minute and 53 seconds.
In surveillance video, you see Officer Oscar Sirenek and Devon Molins wrestle. Here, the officer reaches for his handcuffs. Then, seconds later, another juvenile, a friend of Molins, approaches. The officer orders him to retreat. Meanwhile, Molins reaches towards his waistband.
Devon held a 9mm high-point semi-automatic handgun. Devon was holding the weapon with his finger on the trigger and attempting to move his upper torso and right arm to the left in a spinning motion.
Within seconds, gunfire. At University Hospital, Molins was pronounced dead. This is the gun he had. Police recovered two additional weapons and arrested at least one person nearby. They'd been keeping an eye on Molins and the others since they left the Black family reunion. Earlier in the night, police learned several people outside the event were throwing guns over this fence. Then teens inside were picking them up since security prevented anyone from carrying weapons in. Officer Sirenek was one of several cops watching. He followed Molins on these streets, witnessing Molins hold his waistband where the gun would later be found. Some tonight at the Black family reunion tell us they're angry at the juveniles that started trouble at their celebration, and they call for stronger parenting.
We try to come down here and celebrate the Black family reunion, and they need to make sure, you know, who's getting in. I think that what they need to do when kids come in, 18 and below, they need to be with a parent.
Tonight, the chief promises he's bringing intervention to teens at risk of falling into gang or violent activity and stands by Officer Sirenek's use of force.
And that suspect had his trigger, his finger on the trigger. The officer had no choice.
Molins has been in trouble with police before, but because he's a juvenile, that information on the incident is not public. As for the officer who fired the fatal bullet, he has been involved in a shooting before. Now, we do not yet know details of that incident, but the chief told me he was cleared of any misuse of force in that incident. We're going to bring you more on both of those individuals as it develops. Reporting live, I'm Laura Borchers, News 5.